the Young Turks 14 years.
Welcome back. You're watching Digital Desh Thrive, a special presentation in partnership with NowFloats and Google India. Now, the reason for us to take this journey across four states was to find out how people outside big cities use the internet and their smartphones. Some of the most interesting stories on this 3,800-kilometer journey came from Rajasthan, a pandit in Pushkar who uses a WhatsApp group to keep up with the Vedas, a duo who sell pure-breed Marwari horses via OLX, and a dari maker who uses YouTube to understand international home decor trends. Let's take a look.
बस आईफोन है, लैपटॉप है, कैमरा है, और सबसे ज़्यादा मैं फोन यूज़ करता हूँ, क्योंकि सारे काम हो जाते हैं मेरे।
इसमें हम ज्योतिष शास्त्र संबंधित बातें, यंत्र तंत्र संबंधित बातें, श्रीमद् भागवत कथा, प्रवचन, इसके लिए हम ये इस फोन को यूज में लेते हैं।
इंटरनेट भैया मैं तो कुछ जानता भी नहीं था। एक अंग्रेज ने मेरी वेबसाइट बनाई, उसने मुझे मोबाइल दिलाया, उसने सिखाया मुझे व्हाट्सएप, इंटरनेट। अभी मेरा बिजनेस उसके द्वारा बहुत अच्छा चलता है।
And that was a life-altering intervention for Pavan, whose business has grown manifold, from working for safari operators to owning his own safari business. In Jodhpur, two Bishnoi brothers, Deepak and Dhanraj, have a similar story to share.
2011 में हमने स्मार्टफोन ले लिया था। उस समय 2011 में टीवी में सब में दिखने शुरू हो गए थे, स्मार्टफोन से आप आपका काम स्मार्ट तरीके से कर सकते हैं, बहुत इजी होगा गेस्ट से। नहीं तो पहले हमको हर मेल चेक करने के लिए इंटरनेट साइबर कैफे में जाना पड़ता था, बहुत बार बुकिंग मिस हो जाती थी, क्यों गेस्ट लास्ट मोमेंट पे मेल करता था, और मेल तो हम हर दो दिन में या एक दिन में जाके एक ही समय चेक करते थे।
जैसे कि स्मार्टफोन जैसा हाथ में है तो वी आर गेटिंग अ क्वेरी एंड वी आर रिवर्टिंग द बैक एट द सेम टाइम, सो वी कन्फर्म आवर बुकिंग। सो इट हैज टोटली चेंज लाइक आवर लाइफ, आवर बिजनेस, सॉरी। इंटरनेट से काम करने से हमको सबसे ज्यादा ये फायदा हो गया कि जो भी मिडलमैन हुआ करते थे वो टोटली हट गए। बिफोर लाइक वी वर जस्ट वर्किंग ओनली एज अ ड्राइवर्स फॉर द होटल्स, ट्रेवल एजेंसीज, तो वट एवर अ बिग अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट वॉज गोइंग टू देम।
Apart from TripAdvisor and other travel apps to grow their primary business, the duo also discovered a new business stream via OLX. They rear purebred dogs and horses which they sell online using OLX. Also on offer are refurbished World War II Jeeps.
Actually, ma'am, humne ek ad dekha tha OLX pe kuch bhi bech do.
OLX, ma'am, became a good like a shop for us to sell our things. We don't need any office or anything. We can just post it, all the information and everything, and then it can be easily sold.
But what is it about the new generation of technology that makes it so easily accessible to the common man, someone who perhaps has not even completed his formal education?
In these towns and villages, the one person who adopts it first and uses it effectively typically becomes a champion and thus disseminates that, and you know, call it the offline virality. You know, the software which was being shipped, let's say even 10 years back, always came with a user manual. That does not happen with new technology, new apps, or even new phones. And there's a reason for it. There is a reason why WhatsApp doesn't have a user manual. And then in that reason, NowFloats never has a user manual. The premise is that it has to be so easy, so intuitive, so simple, that you wouldn't need ever to refer to someone to get started. Certainly there are advanced level skills, certainly, that again are available on the same smartphone through a search.
Rooprajji from a village called Salawas near Jodhpur is a case in point. His family has been in the dari making trade for over 300 years, but the growth in the business in the last decade since Rooprajji discovered the internet has been tremendous. From checking his email every few days to every 10 minutes to respond to customer queries, his clients include Mike Jagger and Richard Gere.
स्मार्टफोन आने से मेरे लिए ये आसान हो गया कि भाई दुनिया में किस तरह का रंग लोग इस्तेमाल करते हैं, वेबसाइट देखते रहते हैं, किस तरह के कलर कौन से देश में इस्तेमाल करते हैं, तो उसके हिसाब से हमने कलर को चुनने के लिए ये फोन मेरे लिए काफी अच्छा साबित हुआ है। तो मैं ये देख सकता हूँ कि उसमें लोग ऐसे कलर चाहते हैं, तो उसके अनुसार हम भी हमारे काम में परिवर्तन करते हैं। जब हम दरी बनाने का काम करते हैं तो पहले हम ग्राहक से संपर्क करने में एक दो महीने लग जाते थे, उसके हिसाब से अभी जब स्मार्टफोन इस्तेमाल करते हैं तो एक दो महीने काम होता है तो वो काम एक दो दिन में हो जाता है, क्योंकि उसके तुरंत उनसे संपर्क कर लेते हैं, उनको क्या चाहिए क्या चाहिए, व्हाट्सएप पे या उनको ईमेल के थ्रू नेट के थ्रू उनको भेज देते हैं, उनका हाथों हाथ जवाब आ जाता है। तो काम में भी बढ़ोतरी हुई, क्योंकि पहले जो एक 12 साल भर में जो हम लोग 10 बनाते थे, अभी हम साल भर में 20 बनाने लगे।
Merchants across small towns and villages that we traveled use their own basic websites or existing marketplaces like Snapdeal, Paytm and Flipkart to sell their goods online. What does this mean in the long term for these merchants for whom getting access to bank credit was a tough task?
If you go to one of these e-commerce merchants and ask them what has changed for them, some of them will tell you, they say the biggest thing that has changed is I have become credit rich instead of being credit poor. Earlier I was a supplicant to my bank, I would go and beg for a working capital loan, they will never give it to me. Now I can send my daily sales report for the last 30 days to a possible NBFC, and that NBFC and other NBFCs are competing to give me credit for 30 days, right? In some cases the Flipkarts, the Snapdeals and the Amazons are organizing them. And they'll do this for one class of people. Ola and Uber are doing this for drivers. And all of them are becoming fundable with non-collateral debt. But in other areas, we need to see this happen where there is no Ola, no Uber, but they're self-organizing. And we've seen this happen in other parts of the world. And once that dynamic kicks in, then you will see a whole new economic kind of a landscape emerge. And we look back 5-10 years from now, that would become the biggest basis for economic growth in India, because in every part of the world, it is the small businesses that are the engine of economic growth.
On that note, it's time for us to wrap up this special Young Turks presentation. Do tune in to CNBC TV 18 on Tuesday the 28th of June as we celebrate 15 years of Young Turks at the Young Turks Summit in the capital. It's going to be a day-long celebration that will bring together the original tech startup founders of Infosys in a first-ever joint session. Also, startup enablers Jayant Sinha, Amitabh Kant and Ruchir Sharma, who launches his best-selling book, The Rise and Fall of Nations, at the summit. This is just a glimpse of everything we have lined up for you, so stay tuned to CNBC TV 18's Young Turks Summit on the 28th for all of that and more. Till next week, from all of us here, goodbye, thanks for watching.
The Young Turks 14 years